You want to say that one more time, don't you? Let's do it one more time. Can you do it one more time? Or do I mess y'all up? We're very technologically advanced. I thought you wanted to see that. Good afternoon. You just watched the university's ESPN video that will be shown this year during all of our athletic events that will be televised. This video was created by our own Department of Marketing and Communication. The video illustrates the power of our hands and what we can accomplish when we join together. Congratulations, OMC, on a good job. I think I know most of you, but my name is Lisa Miller, and I'm the Vice President for Enrollment Management and University Relations. And it is indeed my honor to welcome you to this extraordinary facility, the Clark M. Williams Innovation Campus, which was donated to us by Lumen Technologies on June 27th. Today marks the first open event for the ULM family, and actually our very first university event. Yes, it is indeed a great day on the Bayou. We are still on the Bayou, just a little further north. Clark Williams was actually given Marion Telephone Company as a wedding gift in 1946. See what dreams can do? The company grew to become the third largest telecommunications company in the U.S. The campus totals about 800,000 square feet, with about 100,000 of this being the parking garage. Currently, the university leases back space to Lumen for a number of employees. On behalf of the university, I would like to once again thank Lumen for their enormous generosity and their trust in ULM that we will use this facility to maximize its potential to enhance all of Northeast Louisiana and the entire state. Thank you. Today we have several special guests with us I'd like to acknowledge. We have our Monroe Mayor, Friday Ellis. Stand up, Friday. Joining Friday today, we have the CEO of the New Orleans Downtown Development, Davon Barber. Stand up, Davon. Let's give you a welcome. Glad to have you. We also have our Police Jury President, Shane Smiley. Where are you, Shane? There he is. The mayor of Sterlington, Matt Talbert. Are you Matt? Thank you for being here, Matt. We also have former U.S. Congressman Rodney Alexander. Just Rodney, sitting way back there in the back. We also today are so excited to be the first campus for the 2023-24 Management and Leadership Institute participants to visit during their year of leadership development. So I'd like the participants to please stand. Management and Leadership Institute participants. Thank you. We also have our UL System President, Dr. Jim Henderson with us. As part of their inaugural session, Dr. Henderson will be joining them during their meeting following this event. Given that the stars aligned and he was going to be joining us, we have the opportunity to hear from our system president. Let me share a little bit about him. Since his appointment in 2017, he has led the universities of Louisiana in the creation of a strategic framework that charges its universities to produce the most educated generation in Louisiana's history, facilitate growth through public-private partnerships and research, and recruit, retain, and develop world-class faculty who educate students, empower employees, and enrich communities. Previously, Dr. Henderson served as president of his alma mater, Northwestern State University. Before taking the helm of NSU, Henderson also served as chancellor of Bossier Parish Community College. He has been accused of being obsessed with the future of work. He has spent countless hours thinking and discussing the academy's place in new and emerging realities. He recognizes with technology advances, repetitive and predictable tasks are increasing through automation and robotics. Expanding applications of artificial intelligence are accelerating this movement. He believes in order for our graduates to be successful, that they must be prepared with capabilities that technology cannot replace. These capabilities have formed the core of the academy since our earliest days. This was the impetus for a more in-depth conversation with faculty and staff from all 9 campuses. This group, with the leadership of Dr. Henderson, defined the core competencies that will permeate the education each student receives at a UL System University, all while respecting the distinctiveness of each university's mission and culture. If my memory serves me correctly, he also has a Warhawk connection. His uncle was our 5th president of ULM, Dr. Dwight Vines. Please join with me in welcoming Dr. Jim Henderson.
Well, good afternoon. I was asking Dr. Barry, you couldn't find a bigger place to have this event? What a beautiful facility this is, and what an endorsement of confidence in your university, and I think an attestation to its relevance in this regional economy. Mayor, it's great to be with you all today. Thank you for being here, and I think that showcases that town and gown relationship that has so long defined this area. Lisa mentioned my uncle, Dr. Vines. Most of you that knew him knew he was an avid tennis player. And there's a little bit of connection here, so work with me on this. I was 40 years ago, I would come up here on the banks of Bayou Desir to Pat Collins Indian Camp, NLU football camp. And the greatest thing about coming to camp here was you had Dr. Martin on the athletic training staff. And he was one of the leading researchers in heat and how heat affected athletes. So every 8 minutes, a horn would blow, and we'd have to run over to the sidelines and drink some water. It's fantastic for football players, right? Fast forward yesterday, this is the tennis connection. I'm on the tennis court at 2:00 in the afternoon with my 20-year-old son. And after the first set went 82 minutes, one set, I said, son, we've got to get some water. And he says, Dad, water makes you weak. Now, in fairness, he's a Louisiana Tech student, so he's not necessarily bright. That's not fair. I'm sorry, there's some tech. Jamie, is Jamie here? I apologize, Jamie. Where I sit is where I stand. Folks, welcome to another great semester. This year we finished our 4th consecutive highly successful legislative session. The 4 most successful sessions we've ever had in our 50-year history as our system. And yet we are at institutions that are still starved for resources. That's a dichotomy that's hard to put in balance, right? And it's one that keeps me awake at night. We're in a kind of a delicate phase for higher education nationwide, not just in Louisiana, but nationwide. If you look at what's happening in Florida, and you look at what's happening in Texas as a state, Texas very concentrated. If you watch the debacle that just happened at Texas A&M, with some issues in transparency and ethics and character, I will tell you, I don't think there's a more important moment for us, despite technology, to be focused on the core competencies that make not only qualified, talented workers for our economy, but make ethical, contributing citizens for our communities. Because the essence of what we do, whether it's workforce development or economic development or community development, is human development. There's nobody else better positioned to do that in communities in a meaningful way than our universities, and certainly this university and this community is better positioned than most with resources, with human resources. And so please understand the importance of your work, not only today, but for the future. I'm so bullish on the future of work. We could go back into the 19th century when the Luddites were destroying machinery because they knew that advancing technology was going to replace their work. Well, it didn't happen. And we go into the 30s, and John Maynard Keynes was talking about technological unemployment because technology was advancing so quick, there'd be no work for the rest of us. And sometimes we wish that might have happened, but it didn't. It didn't. And in the 60s, Time Magazine put out a great prediction of the future that said by the year 2000, there will not be enough work for the vast majority of people, and we will be spending our time coming up with creative ways to spend our leisure time. And with every advance in technology, there's been an advance in the amount of work that could be done. But hopefully, if you look back in history, we'll see a repeat of that. When we have these eras of advance in technology, there's more meaningful work to be done by humans, but only if we're able to develop those humans to be prepared for it. I am a little bit obsessed with future of work, you're right, but I'm obsessed with it because it's our work. We create the future of work, and we create the citizens that are going to benefit from it, thrive in it, and take control of their own economic and social self-determination. I'm so excited about that. I'm excited to be involved with this work with you, with Dr. and Dr. Barry here. He has been such a joy. They were all at my house. Christine wasn't able to come, but Ron was at my house. For the one time a year, I bring the presidents over, and we eat big steaks, and we drink ridiculous wines, and I get them to vow to do all kinds of incredible things over the next year, and then hold them to it. They're like, did I say that? Well, we videotape everything, so we've got it. If any of you need that for whatever reasons, noble or otherwise, we can share that with you as well. I'm so excited to get to visit with the next session of the Management and Leadership Institute. You have several graduates in the room that are on the faculty and the staff at ULM. They continue to do amazing things here. That program under the leadership of Dr. Caprice Ayoub has developed now, what, 400? How many graduates? 120. All right, 400, 120. Look, the higher up you go in administration, the more loose you are with numbers. That's just the way they teach us that. But 120 graduates of that leadership institute are contributing to our system. I hope it's one that you'll learn more about. If it's something that you're interested in participating in, let your leadership know. If we need to expand it, Caprice has got so much bandwidth that it's untapped that we'll just expand the program again. Delighted to visit with them. Delighted to visit with you. I look forward to visiting with you a little bit more. They should always start the presentation with the wine. I noticed it was on the way in, the bottles were all unopened, and so we're all drinking cucumber water. Hopefully later we'll have a different fruit in the water and enjoy some community together. Thank you for the opportunity to be here, and go Warhawks.
Now I'm going to ask the other vice presidents to join me on the stage. You see how quick they're joining me, don't you? Their eagerness. So we think it's important to welcome our new employees, so each of us are going to do that quickly. And then we have a little game that we're going to kind of make up as we go along to give away our door prizes. So bear with us as we do that. Who wants to kick us off? Come on, Dr. Fields, get the energy going.
Okay. Mountain Moving Monday, everyone. How's everyone doing? Great. So what are my tasks and duties?
You can introduce your new
staff. Okay, so all of the new staff members for the Division for Student Affairs, please stand. I think there's one. All right, two.
Okay, so stand for Dr. Fields. So Dr. Aran has given us some instruction.
Can you do it?
Okay, sure, go for it.
Okay, because it changed since I
It changed, good.
There should be six balls out among you. If you're holding a ball, please stand. Got one. I see two, three, four. We're missing two balls. Okay. All right. That's kind of par for the course, but that's okay. All right. Those who are holding the balls will be the recipients of the door prizes. So if the four of you will come forward, the first one that gets to the stage will get Dr. Fields' door prize.
Dr. Fields, which one's yours?
I don't know.
She thought she actually got one.
You with that
stain. I never did
any of them. Yeah, I can see you.
Congratulations. Thank you. You're welcome. Yeah, the pink and green looks really great. Yeah.
Okay, we're going to recycle.
We're going to recycle? Uh-oh.
I'm about to
turn it around. Yeah, there you go.
Shanti, you're going to have to put it back in when I throw it. This last one. Got to recycle this one too. Okay. This one is for the president. Okay. The president worked long and hard on his door prize. So this is going to be an incredibly valuable ball.
I'm Bill Graves. I'm the Vice President for Business Affairs. I wanted to ask any employee that's in their first year within the Business Affairs Division, please stand. Welcome. Thank you. Also, while I'm up here, I want to ask everybody that's in Business Affairs to please stand up that's a part of that division. I just want to, yes. I just want to thank you all for what you do. A lot of it is behind the scenes and doesn't get noticed near enough, but thank you for what you do. We appreciate it.
Hi, I'm Mike Camille. I'm the Vice President for Information Services and Student Success. And I'd also like the folks who have been hired in the last year in my division, that's IT and Student Success, to stand up. Okay. And everyone in my division, if you would stand up, please. Good. And just like Dr. Graves, I do appreciate what you've done for us. I know you're loyal employees. You work so hard. I see you every day. So thanks for what you do, and I'm really looking forward, and I know you are looking forward to the upcoming year. So thank you all.
How many vice presidents in your mind? Mark Aaron, I'm the Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs here, and I have the complete privilege of serving the faculty and staff as its Chief Academic Officer. So would the new faculty that were hired since last year please stand? Would the new staff since hired since last year, please stand. Would the current faculty please stand? Thank you. Yeah, I said current like you're not going to be later. sorry. Would the faculty that have been here with us for a while then, I'll put it that way, please stand. And finally, would the staff that have been with us please stand from Academic Affairs. Guys, I can't tell you how much I appreciate what you do. And what you're going to see this year is a bunch of very excited students that are going to come want to learn with you and work with you. And as you're going to hear from the president in a few minutes, you're going to make a difference in those lives. I can't wait to see their transformation because of what you do. Have a good evening.
So you can tell that this group of VPs, we're really operating outside of the frame, right? I would like to have all of the staff members for Student Affairs to please stand. Those who are operating remotely, I know there are some of them because we couldn't close every single area, but everyone that's in Student Affairs, please stand. And most of them are just standing in general because they're working. Thank you all so much, and you know that we still have work to do this evening, so I'll see you a little bit later.
And certainly last but not least, any new employees for Enrollment Management and University Relations? They may be standing up already back there. There's Emma. There we go. And now if y'all will be joined by all your fellow peers within the department, my current employees, some of you have been with me since the beginning. So, yay team. We've been working really hard this summer. We're excited about our new Warhawks. Next week they'll be on campus. Wednesday will be convocation coordinated by Dr. Fields' area. And these people have lots of energy and they have worked through the whole summer. And the leader of our summer excitement has been Mr. Ahmad Solomon. And so since he's known to be the man on camp to bring the energy, he's going to come up on the stage and introduce to you some of our Hawk Seekers. Come on, Ahmad. Yes, we're going down.
All right, so I'm a little tall, so I'm going to have to adjust a little. Okay, so my name is Ahmad Solomon. I'm the Director of Orientation Programs and Special Events in the Office of Recruitment. So I got the pleasure of welcoming all of our first-year students this summer through our 5 prep sessions that we had. I also got the pleasure of welcoming our transfer students that are going to be starting. And then this Wednesday and Thursday, I also get the opportunity to welcome our international students. And so all of these students are super excited to be here, and so we just kind of want to keep the momentum going with the excitement. And so I know some of you picked up some little buttons today, and so those of you that did not, as you leave today, you can pick up a button that says, "Got questions, ask me," because we all know how scary it is to start your first semester of college, right? And so we want to make sure that all of these students, the first-time freshmen, the international students, and the transfer students, know exactly who on campus that they can ask questions to. So next week, for the whole week, the first week of classes, we ask that you all join us in wearing these "Got questions, ask me" buttons. And on top of that, we had such an awesome summer with our freshman orientation that we are excited to keep that momentum going into the fall semester with our campus tours. For the first time ever, we will be offering 64 campus tours a week, as well as 14 tours every Friday. And for the first time, we will be offering 8 a.m. tours 3 times a week this fall semester. And so that's going to be really exciting for all of our incoming students to be able to visit campus and us have a plethora of options for them. And so this afternoon, after this event, you guys will get the opportunity to tour this awesome facility, and some of our actual Hawk Seekers are going to be the ones to tour you around. And so we are going to give them the opportunity to introduce themselves to you all real quick, just so you can get a taste of the students that are actually touring prospective students on our campus.
Hello, everyone. I'm a little short, so I'm going to readjust. My name is JC Hobbs. I'm a sophomore pre-pharmacy major from Bastrop, Louisiana.
Hey, everyone. My name is Amaya West. I'm a junior biology pre-med major from West Monroe, Louisiana.
Hello, everybody. Lots of familiar faces. My name is Kewan Smith. I'm a junior communication major from Shreveport, Louisiana.
Let me adjust. How y'all doing? My name is Deshaun Fields. I'm a sophomore pre-OT major from West Monroe, Louisiana.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Sydney Andrews. I'm a senior communications major from Sterlington, Louisiana.
Hey, everyone. My name is Ethan Miller. I'm a sophomore psychology pre-med major from Calhoun, Louisiana.
And finally, good evening, everyone. My name is Michael Crenshaw. I'm a senior finance and computer information systems major from Pineville, Louisiana. And in a moment, I'm going to introduce to you our wonderful university president, Dr. Berry. But before that, if you could direct your attention to the screen for a video.
The thing about time is that it comes and goes. Tomorrow will make today a distant memory, and as quick as you were here, you'll be gone. What's in front of you is an opportunity to make right now something you'll never forget. You have the ability to write history, to create a story that will live with you forever. Think back to all the days leading up to today. All the training, the hours of preparation, the pain you felt. They have brought you to this moment. They are the armor that you wear. Right now is about execution. It's about taking all those hours and turning them into the best version of yourself. Today is about being better than you ever dreamed you could be. These are the moments you live for. Gone are the insecurities, the doubt, the disbelief. This day is yours. Look your opponents in the eye. They cannot give what you can. You have built this opportunity piece by piece. You have created an unstoppable force, and it's finally time to reveal that to the world. Let people doubt you. They'll see with time. Let the obstacles stand. You will run right through them. Let everything in this universe tell you no. You have already told yourself yes. The hardest thing in this world to stop is someone who knows they've won before the game has started. This is your everything. Embrace it. Make it so that you never forget today. The script. There is no tired. You left that in the weight room years ago. There is no unsure. Pushing yourself to exhaustion every day took care of that. There is only when. When do you rise up? There comes a point when you've just given too much. Your sacrifice is too great to accept anything but the very best. Everything else is noise. This is your day. It will not disappear with time. It will live on. You have earned today. Go make sure the world knows.
I don't know about you guys, but I feel like I run a marathon right now. But up next, I'm going to introduce the driving force of that feeling at our university, man that inspires me to be the best version of myself, President Dr. Berry.
Appreciate it.
Well, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Wow. Today is ours. You ready for that? Today is yours. It's ours. We have prepared. You have worked hard. It's yours. You know, when I first saw this video this weekend, I thought, well, timing is everything, right? Friday night, I spoke at an athletic event. Wouldn't that have been perfect for an athletic event? Yeah, that would have been perfect, but instead I had to give a lecture. So I gave a lecture instead of that about perceptions and expectations, and that we really need to raise our expectations so that other people's perspective and perceptions of us change. But if you think about the people in this room, your friends, your colleagues, you start to realize that you could be in that video. There are people in this room that have dedicated their lives to their discipline, to their study, to their research. There are people in this room that are finding cures for cancer, new methods of detecting disease, and providing answers to world's most difficult problems. There are people in this room that have created world-class training and professional development for our next leaders of our University of Louisiana system and our 9 institutions. There are people in this room that are at the top of their game with art and science and English. Words and ideas, if you remember from last year, can and will change the world. And there are people in this room that deserve to be in a video like that. In fact, there are people in here that should be in a video like that because you've put in the effort. You've done the hard work, you've sacrificed, you've been through pain, and you endured. And now, you are providing those services to change lives in a region that so desperately needs you to do that. Thank you. Thank you for being who you are. Thank you for really believing in the mission of ULM and believing in our community. Because without us, there may not be hope. Without you giving of your talents and continuing to develop yourselves, it may not happen. Our community might not have a video like that, but I'm here to tell you, I don't know if you listened to the music before this, but I personally, I'm ready to continue the climb. I'm ready to try everything, and I hope that all of you are ready to go the distance. Because what we started 3 years ago is amazing. There is absolutely nothing that we can accomplish together when we bring our unique talents, our unique gifts together to face the challenges that are facing our world. I'm hopeful that you realize how special you are, how talented you are, how important you are, and how much people appreciate you for being here and giving of yourself and giving your talents to make the world a better place. Now, I said 3 years. This is my third university address. It's hard to believe. But we started together 3 years ago. Oh, go back. And I started out the first university address by saying, it's time we need to own who we are, where we are, and do what we must do together to create better lives for ourselves, for our students, and our community. And the second year, we talked about how and when are we going to do that. And of course, the when is now. We don't want to wait on anything. We want to get to work now. And so last year, the real question was how. And you may remember, some of you who were here, that I created a little video for you. You remember that? It wasn't the golf cart video. Okay? It wasn't that. It was Robin Williams and the Dead Poets Society. You remember that? And I shared with you the quote from Walt Whitman. It's there on the screen for you. You remember that? That the powerful play goes on and you may contribute a verse. So the first year I challenged everyone to figure out their why. What's their purpose? What's their goal in life? What do they want to do? And the next year it's how do we go about doing that? We find our own verse. We find our role. We become the best version of ourselves. And so, We've taken all that and we created what I think is an amazing strategic plan together. And it was a lot of people involved in the community, our students, faculty, and staff. And it's a plan that actually can take us a very long way. It's a plan that actually is a 5-year plan, but if you remember, we said we're going to review it and revise it every 2 years. And this strategic plan had a foundation. Our foundation for our future is built upon our principles and our values, and really, our university resources. Because without resources, we can't do a whole lot. And so, what did we do this last year? What did you do this last year? Amazing things. Absolutely amazing things. We're sitting in one of them. You know, we actually thought we were being audacious. We actually said, you know, the university's got a $100 million campaign going on, and by 2031, we're going to raise $100 million. And I said, well, the rest of the university can do better than that. So outside of the foundation, we're going to raise an additional $150 million in resources by the time we turn 100 years old, 2031. Well, this year, when we are revising and reviewing our strategic plan, you know what we have to do? We have to change that goal because we met it this year. Wow. Isn't that pretty amazing? You did that. This facility alone got us nearly there. But we talked. We built these partnerships with our legislators. They went to bat for us. People all over the state went to bat for us. Dr. Henderson went to bat for us. A record year in the final budget this year for ULM and the capital outlay budget, $90 million for improving our campus. Can you imagine $90 million in? Yeah, it's almost unbelievable. So that's why you're sitting there staring at me, not saying anything. $90 million. Now that includes money to completely renovate Sugar Hall, all 3 floors. Yay, finally, $30 million, which is very exciting. $58 million to totally reimagine Ewing Coliseum, Fant Ewing Coliseum. Not only to refurbish it, but also put alongside it these amazing healthcare facilities. Now, I know most of you know this, but that facility is the state special needs shelter. So in times of disaster, the people who need to be evacuated from South Louisiana or anywhere, those who are coming to us in beds, we host them. Our health sciences students and faculty take care of them. Guess what? The state said, your facility, we can't send anybody in that facility anymore. So we used that as an argument to say, hey, let's rebuild it. Let's reimagine it. Let's put healthcare facilities around it. So now when we host those evacuees, there's medical services right there, including our own pharmacy, including a healthcare, including physical therapy, occupational therapy, and counseling. You don't think people need counseling when they're displaced from their home? Absolutely they do. But then also, it serves as a place for our students and faculty to learn and grow, and for us to do outreach to the rural communities. You know, we also got money at the federal level, $2 million for a statewide weather mesonet. Now, when I heard that, I had no idea what it was, and so I had to learn that it's actually going to provide extremely accurate, more timely information for our citizens across the state. There are going to be these weather pods all across the state managed by our atmospheric sciences program, the best in the world, without a doubt. But $2 million to provide better services and for better safety for our citizens across Louisiana. How about a $600,000 grant for a mobile pharmacy? One of the things we learned during the last disaster was medication was a big issue. No one came with their prescriptions. Wouldn't it be great to have a mobile pharmacy sitting there to help them? During our 24-hour day of giving, Now, this is a true testament to each one of you in this room. First year as president, I think we raised $20,000 in 24 hours. Second year, we raised $40,000 in 24 hours. You helped us raise $2.4 million in 24 hours during our last day of giving. Wow. You did an amazing job to help us make sure that that foundation and those university resources were there. Now, I'm just going to hit the highlights because I think I'm going too long because the bar wasn't open. You know, the bar was supposed to be open so this would go much better. But sorry about that, Dr. Henderson. I don't know what happened. But student success. It's amazing this summer, just like most summers, we had the opportunity to travel all across the state. We went to Dallas, we went to Chicago to meet with our alums. Every one of them had a great story to tell about you. Christine and I were in Sam's Saturday. And we're standing in line, and this young lady turns around and said, "Hey, you're Dr. Barry." I said, "Yeah. How are you? What'd you major in? All this stuff." And she starts talking about how much she loves Brett Bennett and that he prepared her for an unbelievable future. And she couldn't be more happy with her job right now and her life right now. Now, I can tell you, we've heard stories about every program at the university. That one just happens to be the most recent. Because I know what you do each and every day. You meet our students where they are, and you help them get to where they need to be. Thank you for doing that. These alumni really appreciate it. The students appreciate it. It's what we do. It's our business. So faculty and staff development, that's one we're going to continue to work on. Dean Pratt walked up to me when he first got here, and I saw he had a glass of wine earlier, so I don't know how he cheated. He broke in line or something, but he blamed Christine. He walks up to me and he said, "I see you take this faculty and staff development part of the strategic plan really seriously." And I said, "Yeah, we do, John. I mean, it's important. You know, we just opened this fall the new faculty and staff development center. We added additional stipends for promotion and tenure. We're working on plans for new ranks with instructors. We're creating this new development plan, ladder, career ladder for staff. We're doing all these things." He said, yeah, that's all good. He said, "But you made us walk from way over there, over here, and you're making sure we get our wellness exercise. And so you're welcome. You know, unfortunately, you're going to have to walk back. So you got two for the price of one today." But no, we do take that very seriously. You know, Dr. Arendt brought in, and this really relates to both student success and faculty and staff welfare and distinction, brought in a consulting firm to look at everything we do in the academic side to try to help us right-size our programs, right-size our faculty and staff. And it's, you know, we're understaffed. We need to figure out what each program needs to be successful. Which staff level do we need in certain areas to be successful? So he's got a lot of great data that will lead a lot of discussions this year about right-sizing what we do, all in the spirit of making sure that your work life, home balance, work-life balance is better, because we know you're working an awful lot. And so we are working on that. I want to thank Dr. Arendt for working on it. Intellectual activity, how about that grant, the largest grant? Are our pharmacy people in here? $2.1 million, one of the largest grants in the history of the institution. More importantly, do you know what it was for? It was to help first responders be better prepared to interact with people who are dealing with substance abuse issues. So now our faculty, our students are learning and training first responders to help somebody have a better life. So instead of a policeman just taking someone that's obviously on opioids or something, instead of taking them directly to jail, they can redirect them to more appropriate services. It's truly outstanding, truly amazing. And then at December of this last year, We had already passed the total amount of federal research dollars that we had earned the year before. That's because of you. That's because what you do every single day. So thank you for that. Community engagement. Thank you, Dr. Pratt, for starting that. We appreciate that. Community engagement, you know, our partners are here. We have unbelievable relationships with the cities, the police jury, our legislative delegation, our education systems, Bossier Parish, we just signed a new agreement with them. Delta Community College, we got lots of agreements with them. We got students going to a military academy, and their students coming here in another country. It's absolutely amazing the engagement that has occurred and is happening to, again, provide opportunities for our students to have a better life. And those things also create lots of opportunities for us. Now, I'm just going to skip the last one because that's the hardest one up here. John Hartwell, where are you? You want to come up? No, I'm joking. So when we developed our strategic plan, we all agreed that for our university to be as successful as possible, we needed to make athletics work. Because that's our number one marketing right there. Whether we like it or not, if our sport teams win, our enrollment goes up. It is what it is. So I just don't want to talk about it. No, Friday night I challenged them. And so I actually told them, you know, as president, I'm one of the last people to find out things. So right before I went up on stage, I looked at Seth. Seth did an amazing job emceeing the event. I said, Seth, so what's my role? Because I was about to go up and speak. And he said, bring it home, Dr. Berry. Bring it home. That's your role. And Coach Bowden had shared with John, and I didn't know this, but they've got a slogan this year. And the slogan is, it's time. And so since I figured if the football coach should say it's time, then I could get up there and tell every head coach to stand up in front of these 400 people. And I look at them and I said, it's time. Athletic excellence, it's time. Now, they all agreed. Now, there was more to my speech than that. But it's all about expectations. And it's all about perspective. It's all about what you think you can do. And that's one reason I played that video. I know it's really not a perfect fit. But when I found that video, it kind of moved me a little bit. Because many times we don't stop to think about how far we've come. We don't stop to think about what we've become ourselves and what our friends and colleagues have become. You're amazing. You're absolutely amazing. Just think about it. Some of you spent 10, 11 years working on your doctorate. If you're like me, maybe some of you did it quicker. You spent hours in labs. It's amazing when you stop and think about where you are and what you've become. And I just need you to know it's time. It's time for you to realize that and accept that and truly give yourself completely. Live like you've never lived. Embrace who you are. Embrace your talents. Give them freely. And I promise you, you'll be more excited, more happy than you've ever been in your life. Now, this next thing I want to put on the board, Chrissy, comes from Nelson Mandela. And it's, there is no passion to be found playing small in settling for a life that is less than the one you are capable of living. Now, that quote means something to me. It hit me. Am I really living the life I need to live? Am I really pushing as hard as I can push? Am I really giving it my all? Am I really ready to go the distance? Am I going to continue that climb? Because there really is no passion in playing small, especially when each one of you in this room has so much talent earned talent. You have developed it. You have built it. It's time for you to share it with the world. It's time for people to realize that ULM is not just a regional university hanging out there, a little sister of the University of Louisiana Lafayette. You know, right before this, I welcomed our transfer students for pharmacy. And so it was a group, and we were having a great conversation, and I asked this young man, which university are you transferring from? And he said, University of Louisiana. And I said, which one? And he said, what do you mean? And so we had this conversation, and I told him, you know, the best quote of last year, when we beat University of Louisiana Lafayette, the SGA president was here on campus, and our SGA president looked at him and said, guess what? We just helped you find your lost L. So this guy continues looking at me, you know, and I continue going around the room, and there's a guy from Tech, and I said, I'm sorry, I've never heard of that. Where is Tech? And he says, Louisiana Tech, you know? And he really thought I didn't know. But those Louisiana Tech people, Dr. Henderson. So this guy, at the end, I look at him and I say, you still look confused. And he said, I've never heard it referred to as University of Louisiana Lafayette. Wow. You know what? We don't need another L, because we are who we are, we're where we are, and we're doing what we need to do to change lives and create a better community. There is no doubt about that. You can see it in everything we do. We can see it in the alumni that we visit with. We were in Dallas, and this gentleman we connected with hadn't been engaged with the university in a long time. And John and I sat down, and we were talking with him, and in his story, he tells us, you know, I went to ULM, I was playing football, I got hurt, so my football career was over. He graduated from ULM in 2.5 years, undergraduate degree, got his MBA, then went off and worked. He now runs a billion dollar portfolio of hotels around the country. He is one of the top 10 private owners of hotels in the United States. Wow, you did that. And so he comes to the presentation. We had, I don't know, 30, 40 people join us for dinner that night in Dallas. And I'm up there telling the story about you, talking about how amazing you are still and how you're changing lives every single day. And I look back there and his wife is handing him tissues. And I'm saying, boy, he's got some bad allergies. I didn't know allergies were in the summer in this heat. And he comes up afterwards, and he says, Dr. Berry, you brought it all home. It's come full circle for me. I never realized what that university, what my university did for me. And so he says, I can write a check. I can hire your students. I can create internship opportunities. I'll do whatever I can do to continue to support the faculty and staff who gave me the life that I have now. And so, you know, the immediate answer was, yes, I'll take the check, I'll take the jobs, I'll take the internships. But instead, I said, you know, Jesse, I think the first step back for you would be come to campus, re-engage on campus, and talk to our faculty and staff and get engaged with our students again. And so guess who our keynote speaker was Friday at our athletic event? Jesse Blair. Now, he introduced us to his wife, and I kept looking at her hand thinking, what is that? It was an 8-carat diamond ring. Wow. So, Mr. Mayor, we're going to get that check. Okay? We're going to work on that. There are all kinds of stories out there like that because of you. because you gave it your all. You invested in our students. You gave of your talents, your knowledge, your wisdom to create a better life for somebody. So last year I did share with you that we did the Robin Williams Dead Poets Society. And it was about really each individual person finding their voice, figuring out where they could play a role in this big scheme of ours to change lives where we are, because that's what we need to do. And there was a gentleman that wrote a song, don't worry, I'm not singing it, about, he was inspired by that movie. He wrote this song for his four-year-old son, but it later went on to be used to raise millions of dollars for cystic fibrosis. Now, first of all, I want to apologize to the Office of Marketing and Communications because I butchered their videos when I did this. So they're not to blame for the videos. They create amazing videos. But I thought it was important to share this song with you, and then I'll tell you why right after.
Take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, they're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. I live.
video and music, thank you, kind of sums up what we do each and every day, what you do each and every day. If you saw some of those moments in there, our third grade reading project, where you invited 2,500 kids, third graders, to our campus, and you read to them and gave them hope and inspiration about a better future, a better life ahead. And then you went on and created a program that follows them now to the fifth grade, where we engaged with them. We invite them back to campus and give them medallions where they can be on campus and attend any event. I'm happy to announce that very soon, we've already bought the books. Those books will go to every parish that we serve. And in that book, each one of those students will be said, they'll learn that they too are Centennial Scholars, and that that book represents a $500 scholarship and all of our belief and encouragement in their future, because that's what we do. We're in this for the long term. It's not a day-to-day job. We're creating futures for people. We are indeed creating the future that they're going to participate in. You are preparing your students for jobs and careers that don't yet exist. That's why the core competencies are so important, about teaching our kids how to communicate, how to be resilient, how to really be self-aware, how to solve problems and make decisions. It's critically important that we continue doing what we do each and every day, because those students deserve every opportunity to be the best version of themselves, just like each one of you in this room today. Our education program is doing phenomenal things. This summer they had students from all across the state on campus, preparing them to be the next leaders in the classroom. Right here at ULM, we're leading the effort to fill the classrooms across the state. It's amazing what each one of you do. It really is. And I just want you to know how very much you are appreciated, how much you're valued, because what you do is literally changing lives and creating futures for people that may not have any hope. But you give them that hope by what you do every single day. And so my hope for you this year is that you live, that you enjoy your life, that you really accept who you are and the amazing person that you are, that your job doesn't define you, but by sharing your talents and your gifts, you are really creating an amazing future for our region. It's you who makes the difference, each one of you. And it doesn't matter if you're in the classroom. The thing that I hear most when I'm traveling from alumni is, oh, I was back in campus, I was back in the city. The city looks amazing, and the campus is beautiful. And the first thing I say is, wait till you see the inside. Wait till you talk to our faculty and staff now. Come see how excited they are to be here. And by the way, send your kids here, because they will change their lives for them. So the bar is open. Before we go and have refreshments and drinks, I think there's actually food out there, and take tours. Thank you. Thank you for what you do each and every day. We may be a small institution of 8,500 students, but those 8,500 students are going to have amazing lives, amazing futures because of you. So thank you for that. Have a great semester. I'm sure it's going to be awesome because you're here. And let's continue on that climb. Let's try everything. And what's the last one? Go the distance. Thank you very much.